This episode is sponsored by Genomics Nutrition, the future of nutrigenomic testing. Welcome, Dr. Stewart. How are you?
I'm doing great today.
Well, good, good. Well, this episode is about and is for providers. You know, we have people that are registering to become genomics nutrition providers and offering the nutrigenomic test kit. So we want to get into a little bit more of the medical side. So tell us, first of all, why a medical professional would want to offer this to their patients.
Well, the better question is probably why a medical professional would not want to offer it, okay? Because what this essentially does is tells us exactly what that patient needs for their nutrition.
Okay.
Meaning, do they need vitamin D? Do they need methylation support? Do they need help with their inflammatory status? Do they need specific vitamins that are unique? Do they need help supporting their mitochondria? Mm-hmm. Do they need help with enzymes? Do they need probiotics? All these important things that you want to know for your patient.
Okay. And so this is going to make a provider better.
I mean, without a doubt. In fact, your patients are going to love you.
Yeah. Well, I have a few providers that have already said this is going to bring validation to my practice.
That's correct.
You know, so tell us a little bit how you use it. I mean, you've been looking at genetic testing in your practice for quite some time.
Right.
But how does this dial it down to this
before genetic testing became widely available, basically what I would do is use the chemistry and I'd see a marker in the blood and I'd say, how did that marker become abnormal? And so I'd go back to the chemistry and I'd essentially start putting in what I thought was important.
And so it would work with a lot of patients.
Yeah. And then we would
with
use
me, it worked.
Right. We would use outcome models, basically look at how the inflammation was in the nervous system, how did the immune cells respond in blood work or in diagnostic testing to tell us whether we were doing good or not.
Yeah.
We don't have to do that anymore.
Because it's there in a report.
What we can do is we can see the entire pathway, each enzyme, what's important, where is the weakness, and where do we need to put it back in? And do we need this specific supplement or do we not? Because the last thing a patient really wants, they don't want 20 bottles of supplements.
God, no. You can't take that many.
It's too expensive.
Listen,
I see people that come in with 50 to 100 bottles all the time.
Okay. And some of these are children they're trying to give them that many supplements.
That's correct. So the problem is when you have that much, you're putting a huge financial burden on the patient.
Yeah.
Your quality of care, having them take that many supplements, is just not going to be good because they're going to get tired.
Okay.
They're going to run out of specific ones at the wrong time. Therefore, the recipe's wrong.
Yeah.
Okay. And so we just need to know how do we prove to the patient this is what you need.
And this report also can help with nutrition, not just supplementation, but the foods you eat and the way your diet is.
Now, Carol, what you're going to notice on our report is I put the bibliography at the back.
Yeah, the references.
The references to show that this is real science, because other practitioners who are not into nutrition, they love to say that this is a bunch of crap.
Okay.
And I hate that. It drives me crazy because all that means is they have not read the medical literature.
Yeah, there's a lot of references at the back of this report.
Oh, my goodness. Okay, it took me a long time to put it all together.
Yeah.
But the long and the short of it is we want you to know that this is science, okay? And this science is really important because it relates to healing, because ultimately what we're trying to do for all of our patients is maintain health and heal them, not just cover up their symptom.
Uh-huh.
And MDs are really bad about that.
Putting a Band-Aid on a symptom.
Just cover up your symptom and hope you magically come out of this, okay?
But the underlying is the nutrition.
You've got to feed the right things to the cell for that to happen, and that is the foundation of biochemistry. So I tell patients that genetic testing has been awesome for me because it validated everything I was saying beforehand.
Yes, yes.
But then it was even better because I could then see a whole lot of things that I could never see before.
Yes, and it's very affordable too.
Correct.
You know, for the patient, which nice.
You know, I'm a father of four, and so I'll tell you what happens. If I see a mom or a dad who has had some problems, the last thing they want is their babies to go through that.
What they went through.
Oh, they just don't want it.
Oh, yeah.
And so, or if you've had a child that's been affected with autism or a developmental delay or any kind of sickness, they don't want that for their other children.
Mm-hmm.
And so what they want is they want to know as early as possible, how is this going to happen? Instead of being reactive, putting out fires, waiting for something to happen, we can actually look at the genetics as early as the first week or two of life if we choose to.
Yeah. You know, what I get a lot of with neurobiologics is people calling or coming in and saying, my grandfather has Alzheimer's and I don't want to get it. So, right. you know, it doesn't mean you're going to get it. But if you can look at their genetics nutritionally mm-hmm. and put in the right support, hopefully that won't happen down the line. Right. We can't say it won't, but it could be a better chance because you're raising the status of the body's health.
Right. And Kara, when we finally see this, I'm learning new stuff every week.
Oh, yeah. I know this test is going to add more SNPs.
Well, and so it's definitely going to add more SNPs because I'm learning more and more. And it's just because it interests me and I'm always interested in making my patients better. And so this is going to make you or allow you to help your patients mm-hmm. from not only just a medicinal side, because they don't want to take medicines. No yeah. patient wants to take medicines. They will if they have to. But if we can fix the underlying problem, the chance of getting off the medicine is much higher.
And you also talk about, too, when you improve the methylation pathway and some of the other pathways that it could help your prescription if you absolutely need it, possibly work better.
Oh, there's no doubt about it.
You know, because mm-hmm. the body will function better, therefore the medication will work better.
Right. And so what's important is that we leave this in the hands of the professional. Even though it tells us what we need, the professional still has to understand what's going on in the biochemistry here. How can we make the patient understand? So what's happening is it actually makes the physician look really, or the practitioner look really good. Mm-hmm. Because they're able to say, see, this is exactly what's wrong with you. Because a lot of patients just want to know, what's wrong with me?
Why do I feel this way?
Why do I feel this way?
And, you know, I hear a lot, because I'm always around the consumers, that I went to this doctor, he sold me like 12 bottles and I cannot afford it.
Correct.
And I hear your patients come in, well, Dr. Stewart took me off like 10 of my products and now we're down to 2. And I'm like, you know what? Because he probably read your genetic report and realized that you didn't need a lot of those products.
Yeah, I would say the average patient probably needs 3 to 4.
Just depending.
5.
Yeah.
Depends on, and you know, it can change over time. Some of our products are symptomatic.
Uh-huh.
And some of
like
our products.
Like the Neuronites is for people who are having sleep issues
so
from time to time.
A lot of times you have to help that until you get the body back to normal, and then they won't need it as much.
Yeah, and you know, I get that question all the time, methylation. So this is what I was going to get to. A lot of the providers, everybody, MTHFR, and we're going to get that into our next episode on all the SNPs we're going to dial mm-hmm. down into. But methylation is not the end-all, be-all.
No.
So these tests out there that just do methylation that are $600-$700, it's not giving you enough information. You've seen those tests. What can you get from that?
Well, the answer is you get one part of one pathway instead of getting the whole pathway.
And they all correlate.
Correct. So the whole idea is until you look at the whole pathway of methylation. So I have lots of people that show up that don't have an MTHFR, but they got a bad methylation problem.
With the MTRR or something,
well,
or the FOLR?
It's the FOLR. It's the D, the dihydrofolate reductase. And so you got to look at the whole pathway.
All that's on our report.
Correct.
And it's a beautiful, I have to give you kudos to the beautiful reports and, you know, the definitions that you provide per SNP. You know, I look at other, there's not a lot of companies out there that do nutrigenomic. We are kind of at the cusp of mm-hmm. bringing this to market. And the definitions are, like you said, Wikipedia, very textbook, very doom and gloom. You provided clinical definitions.
Well, they're biochemical definitions.
Okay.
What does that SNP do? How does it hurt you? How does it help you? How does it modify the situation? And what do you need to do about it?
Okay. Well, that's beautiful. I love it. So the report is 7 pages long, and it's great. It's easy for the doctors to print off and give the patient a copy, and mm-hmm. it's an easy cheek swab, which makes it so nice. There's no,
sure.
no a lot of saliva involved. There's no blood involved mm-hmm. like a lot of tests out there. It's a simple cheek swab with this really cool wand that's
well, and what
easy.
You're going to find out is that once you may have one, the patient that comes to see you do it. Now, once they see the outcome, they want the whole family.
Yeah. Yeah, interesting, because, you know, we just, through all the beta testing that we went through and we got all of our family's reports back, you and I are siblings, but mm-hmm. we still had some different
sure
things going on.
You were way more messed up.
I know I was. Thank you very much. I already share that on the other show. But Dr. Stewart, I appreciate your time today, and I hope that as providers that you'll go visit our website at genomicsnutrition.com. And to get into the private sections, you will have to register to have an account. Or just give us a call, 844-258-5564. And we have people on hand to answer questions for you. And everybody have a blessed day. For more information on Genomics Nutrition, please visit our website, www.genomicsnutrition.com, or call 844-258-5564.
858-5564. This podcast is for entertainment purposes only. This information does not replace the opinion and advisement of your own healthcare provider. Products mentioned are not certified by the Food and Drug Administration and are not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease.